Buddy,
yeah, it's snowing.
It looked like it was snowing in our hallway. That is how into Christmas in July we are into.
It is not snowing outside.
No.
Total opposite.
Yeah, Ron Smiley would be very alarmed if it were snowing outside all of a sudden. But anyway, Selena Pompiani is joining us on this
Hello.
Friday because Heather has a long weekend. Mm-hmm. And we want to begin with a big thank you to you. You know, yesterday we had our halfway to the Children's Hospital Free Care Fund Telethon benefit drive. And we want to announce the results because it's very impressive. We are so thankful. $18,250.
That's incredible.
Yeah. And in honor of the 67th year of the telethon, we actually had 67 calls during PTL. So how about that?
Mm-hmm.
109 viewers from three different states made contributions. So you guys really came through. And you know, we know that times are tough right now. So this is really amazing. And thank you.
It was awesome. Even being there, you were providing me with updates. Jill was in my ear giving me updates. And it was so nice to keep getting those. Another $100.
Right.
Another $100.
You felt the excitement
yeah.
of it. And the other thing we want, as soon as you mentioned yesterday that you used to be on the show, tap dancing.
Oh, yeah.
I messaged Selena and I said, is there video of this? And guess what?
We found video.
Found video out of the Pompiani
storage
video vault.
Unit. Yes. My mom, Lisa, went to the storage unit yesterday. That's mm-hmm. where we have all of our old tapes. And she found a few. So I popped it in, David, and I took some video.
Look at this. So this is you and Chelsea.
Yep. And we danced, I don't know how many years. I think since I was maybe 4 or 5 years old, we danced, we tap danced.
Oh,
on
Here's
the show.
Your dad. Yeah.
And we had so many good memories. Chelsea and I loved being part of it. So that's why I still love to be part of it. You know, yesterday was so cool for me. A lot of good memories.
And you know what? You have to show me some moves because can you still tap dance?
I love to tap dance.
Dan. Really?
Yes. You know what? I can't remember. I think it was in January when I did a live shot and you and Heather were hosting and I was at, where was I? I did a live shot with this fabulous tap dancer who was in town on tour. Her name was Sarah.
Oh, I do remember this.
Yes.
And yeah. And she, they
I was at the Cabaret
right.
Theater.
Oh, yeah. And you did. You were good.
And she gave
yeah.
me a few little lessons to refresh my memory, and I loved it. So we should definitely do
okay.
that, David.
I have no dancing ability, so this will be a riot.
I bet that's a total lie. I bet you're good.
No, I'm really not. All right, you know, people are so starved right now for any semblance of a vacation.
Oh, yeah.
You know, getting on a plane, maybe taking off. So take a look at what they did in Taiwan. Now, we have pictures to actually prove that they did this.
So I can't believe this.
Someone invented this idea. They had pretend go abroad trips. So people went to the airport. They went through the rigmarole of getting on the plane. 60 people boarded the plane at a time, and it went nowhere. They just sat there.
But it's amazing how many people wanted to do this.
I know thousands of people signed up for this. And, you know, no onboard meal, nothing. But,
nothing.
You know, you sat on the plane in your mask. And, you know, it's just, I mean, I think it speaks to how much people really do want to get away. And
they want to go
somewhere
far. I could yeah. see maybe a lot of people doing that if they had mimosas or some type of wonderful,
right.
you know, even a tropical cocktail to pretend like you're going to the beach, but just to sit there, that's interesting.
It is interesting. That's why we wanted to show you the pictures, because we thought, whoa. All right, something else we want to show
mm-hmm.
you. If you're a fan of Survivor, there is a teenager in Vermont. You need to see his backyard, because he loves Survivor so much that he has built an at-home version in his yard. He was born 5 years after the show debuted, and he mm-hmm. became obsessed with it. So he and his friends now have these challenges, all inspired by the show. And every detail as close as possible. They even have the torch ceremony where, you know, they vote people out.
And I'm wondering, looking at his backyard, they got a lot of room there.
They do.
Wow.
Well, if you're going to stage a television show, you need
some
space.
Yeah, you better have a lot of space.
All right, let's listen to why he says he did this.
I love this show so much that I do hope to work on it. So I would decide I want to go all out and this would be some type of resume for me. So I just want to be as immersive as possible.
Lincoln, the tribe has spoken.
The tribe has spoken.
Wow.
So who knows? Maybe he'll be the next Jeff
knows?
Probst.
I could see that happening. That's impressive.
All right, well, as we mentioned at the top of the show, this is Christmas in July week here on PTO, so we're wrapping things up today.
No!
Yeah, it's coming to an end, Selena.
I would love it to continue.
You think we should continue it?
Yes.
It'll have to be Christmas in August next week.
That's okay.
Okay,
I
all
like
right.
It.
Well, Jill's not here today, so, you know.
That
Selena
may be a no.
is just, yeah, maybe a no. But you've been looking into the most popular toys. I mean, I know it's early to start buying for the actual Christmas, but you have a good list put together.
I do,
right?
Yes. And I found this yesterday, David. This is from toybuzz.org. And some of these I have never even heard of. So these are the most popular toys for kids coming up this Christmas. At first, right here, we have the Star Wars animatronic edition.
The little Yoda moves in some way or something,
yeah,
I guess.
And I know nothing about Star Wars.
Okay.
I have never seen one.
Really?
I don't know. I know. I'm going to get a lot of heat for this. And I should have at least seen one of the movies, but I haven't. So I don't even know any of those characters.
All right. Well, that was Yoda. I'm pretty sure that was Yoda.
That was Yoda. I think I knew him too. Well, I like this one. I could get on board with this up next. So these are the LOL dolls. They're the Oh My God Surprise Lights fashion dolls. And I think they're kind of cool. I didn't hear about these until Heather, I remember. She mentioned them on the show one time.
Okay.
Maybe Lila or Sunny was into them and bought them. But
what's the lights part? Do they light up?
I think they light up, yeah. Oh. Which is cool, I guess.
Huh. Yeah, no, so, hey.
I like those, and I also like this next one. I want this right now, actually. This is the this is the Barbie Dream House with an elevator.
Oh, wow.
It has
everything. It's a big house if it has an elevator.
Yes, and one of the Barbies that it comes with is actually handicapped, which is awesome that they created that for her.
Right,
for the Barbie
to represent
to get upstairs.
Yeah, people with disabilities. That's fantastic. Yeah.
Yeah. So we also wanted to share... This is big too, David. Paw Patrol. this is the Paw Patrol Paw Dino Patroller. That's a handful there.
That's a mouthful, yeah.
Yeah, so these are just a few, of course. There's a lot on that list. So we have everything for you. We're going to post the link online to their link. It's toybuzz.org. So they had so many I was looking through yesterday, but again, I really didn't recognize a lot of these toys.
Well, it's been a while since you were in the market for toys.
Yes, it has.
Although the Barbie Dream House you do want.
I want that,
put it on your list.
David, you feel free to buy that for me this Christmas.
All right. It's nice to know in advance what I might get you. That's good. All right, well, it is time for our Friday free-for-all where we answer your questions, the ones that you have posted on our Pittsburgh Today Live Facebook page. And so we have a lot that we want to try to get to. And Monica is asking, if you had time for a new hobby, what would it be? Selena.
Mine would be tennis. You're a big tennis player.
I do love tennis.
I have always wanted to get into it. It seems like a lot of fun and a good stress reliever and just a good activity to do outdoors.
You know, I could, not that I'm a good tennis player, but I could teach you tennis. You could teach me golf. I have never played golf. I've hit the ball a few times, and I've been to Top Golf, which was a lot of fun.
I saw you did a piece there.
And I think I did okay there, but I have no, I mean, I watch golf on TV, and I think.
It's hard.
I really hard.
It's really hard.
It's so much harder than, they make it look kind of easy on TV because they're professionals.
I don't know if I would be the best teacher, but I like this.
We'll swap. All right, CJ is asking, he wants to know, do we have pet peeves? Do you have a pet peeve? It seems like nothing bothers you. Like, you have a good attitude that you let things roll off your back, right?
Yes, most of the time. There is something bothers me a little bit. So I have a problem with people who talk too much. We were born with one mouth and two ears for one reason, David. I think it's good. Of course, it's great. You want a good talker.
Right.
But I think it's really important to listen too, and I think a lot of people lack that ability. You know, they just want to hear themselves talking.
That's true.
You got to do both.
Right.
Right?
Now I'm very self-conscious.
No, David, you are perfect. Yes. What about
Thank
you?
Thank you. I'm glad. You know what? I don't know that I have a pet peeve like that. I agree with you people who don't listen, because we've all been stuck in a conversation with someone who just wants to be heard and not ask you any questions.
Follow the body language.
Yeah. I would say Gary's pet peeve I will adopt, and that is people who drive in the passing lane, but they're not passing. They stay there.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my gosh. When we're on the road, every single person, there's another one. He spots them. All right, Craig wrote to us, and this is a great idea. So we were talking about reading to kids earlier this week, and I showed the book that my friend got published. Craig says that in their family, they have a Christmas tradition. Every Christmas, they would give their kids 12 individually wrapped books, and then they open one at Christmas, and then on the 25th of each month after that. So they could sort of extend Christmas all year long and extend the love of reading, and the kids would always have something new to open. So we thought that was a great idea.
That is a great idea.
To share that.
Yeah, that's an awesome idea. I love that. Okay, the next question is from Eric. Eric said, how many Christmas trees do you put up? They put 18 up a year. 18.
Oh my gosh, your house must be, he must have like a Barbie dream house.
We should do a story
house.
On it.
Yes, we should come to your house, Eric, and do
yes,
a story.
Eric, invite us.
How many, I mean, do you guys do more than one Christmas tree?
We do. Let me see. We have, of course, one big main real tree that my parents, they put up in the family room. We have, I would say, maybe three or four, but they're smaller trees. Okay. We just have one main tree.
One main tree. Okay.
What about you?
And I, no, we put up, we have a small tree, actually, that we've started doing. We used to put up a tree on our back deck. Because we have a small house and the piano takes up a lot of room, and so we wouldn't put the tree up inside. Now we put up a small tree, but we used to put up a tree just with lights on the back.
I love that.
And you'd see it through the French doors.
Yeah.
So
that's
anyhow,
very nice.
All right, we are out of time for questions, but we appreciate the questions and we'll do this again next Friday. All right. Well. Coming up next, in the spirit of Christmas in July, we're going to be talking about gifts from the garden and gifts for the gardener as well. Doug Oster shares all of that with Mikey, and look, he has his Santa hat on and everything. We will find out about all of that and the mysterious free seeds that people are getting in the mail. Should you plant them? Should you not plant them? We'll find out what to do coming up next.
And look who else is getting in the spirit of Christmas in July. Only Poolside. I like this. Here's Penguin, our PTL pup. He is here for his Friday pup date, so we'll check in with him just ahead.
He has a Santa hat, too. Plus, we love that Selena is honored on Pittsburgh Magazine's new Best of the Berg issue. Coming up, we'll find out who else is being honored in the new edition in all sorts of different categories.
Oh, David, you're too kind. Well, this is all coming up just ahead on this Friday, July 3rd. 31st, 2020.
Wow.
The last day of July. Thanks so much for being with us.